Hello and welcome to this video. In case you have a classified ad WordPress site with Glacera or any other theme as well, or you have an e-commerce website and you want to offer discounts to your users, I will show you how to set up it one. And I will also demonstrate to you the meaning of the types of coupons we have. We have the percentage discount, the fixed cart discount, and the fixed product discount. Now, this is my site for example, and I have three paid clients. Let's quickly see how to activate the coupons. So I go to my back end. Here's my dashboard. Then under WooCommerce, coupon is supposed to be one of these, but it's nowhere to be found. So what it means is this. I'm going to go to settings and enable the coupon. So I open this new window. And under settings, then under general tab, I go down and I see enable coupons. So I check on this box and I click on save. Now, when I refresh this page, I have my coupons here. So I click on it. I'm going to click on add coupon. On the first field here, I'm going to put my coupon code. You can give your coupon code anything you feel like, as long as it's easy to share to your users. So I'm going to just say Glacera 50% off. Now, description. This is just for documentation purpose. Your user don't get to see whatever you put here. So I'm just going to put something here to remind me of the kind of coupon I created. Okay, so I'll say anything at all. Okay. Then coming down to this place, we have general usage limits and usage restrictions. So I go to the first under general, and when you come here, I'm going to start with this percentage discount. I choose percentage discount. Then let's say for example, I want to offer 50% discount to my users. So it means that they are going to get half of what they are supposed to pay. Now here we don't require shipping, so this is off. Don't touch this. Now coupon expiry date. Now today is 19th of September, so I'm going to say this coupon will run for 1 week, for example. Choose 1 week. Today is 19th, so I choose 26th. And I go to usage restriction. Here, I'm supposed to put the minimum amount one can have before you are eligible to use this coupon, but I don't want to go with these two. So now here I said check this box if the coupon can be used in conjunction with other coupons. Cannot, yes, I don't want to use this coupon with other coupons, so let's check this box. Now check this box if the coupon should not apply to sales items. I want this coupon to apply to sales items, so I don't check. As simple as that. Then when you come down to this place, products, here it says product that the coupon will be applied to. If I need this coupon to be applied to a specific product, for example, these are my products, half standard, platinum, and premium. So assuming I want to apply a particular coupon to a particular product, displayed for me here, like I want this coupon to be applied to standard below. Here comes standard, but I don't need that. I don't need that. I need the coupon to be applied to the whole product I'm selling. And in this case, the three of these plants. So these three are my products. So I don't touch anything here. I go to the last option here. This says usage limit per coupon. When I leave this empty, it means there is no limit to my coupon. But I want just 10 usage, which means after the 10th time of using the coupon, it becomes invalid. So here it says how many times this coupon can be used before it is void. Just 10 times, then the coupon is void. Alright, now limit usage to X item. So here it says the maximum number of individual items this coupon can be applied to when using product discount. Leave blank to apply to all qualifying items in carts. The next option here does not apply to the first does not apply to this percentage discount. So we leave this empty. Now use it limit per user. Now how many times can a user apply this coupon? I said I just make it once. So I click on publish. Now my coupon is ready to use. So what I'm going to do is now is to test this coupon. So here I have a user is logged in. This user has no package. So this user wants to buy a package. Here are the packages. So we try buying the $50 package only and see how it goes. From here, this user will say purchase at plan. And here is the $50 plan. So I click on purchase and view cart. So here we are, the price is $50 and we are being offered 50% discount. So let's see how it turns out. So here I choose, I'm gonna apply the coupons here. So here is the coupon code. I'm gonna copy that. Come here. Now the subtotal is 50 and total is 50 before the coupon. So let me paste the coupon right now and apply my coupon. And what we have here, 50% means half of the original price. So 50 and half of 50 is 25. So 50% means half of the price. So this user will end up paying $25 instead of $50. So this is how we arrived at this $25 here for the $50 plan. Now let's assume the user wants to buy the 3 plans. Let's go check it out. On a normal day, this 3 plans is supposed to cost $100. But let's go see what happened. So here now, I'll try to remove the coupon first so that we can have a clear understanding of what we are doing. Okay, so coupon has been removed. So I go back here now. I have this $50 plan already, so I'm going for the $30 plan now. Click on purchase now and view cards. And the same way, I'm going to purchase the $20 as well. So I open this page and click on purchase on the $20 plan. Click on view cart. And here we are. I have the $50, $30, and $20 plan, and all together we have a subtotal of $100. Now let's go again and apply the coupon and say apply. Now coupon code applied successfully. So again, we have half of the price of what we expected to pay because it's the 50% off or discount. So instead of paying $100, we're going to pay $50. So that is how the percentage discount actually works. Now, I'm going to change this 50% to something like 10% and see the outcome. So I go back to my back end, and instead of 50, I'm going to say 10% off, and I'm going to say update. Now back to my cart, I need to reload this page and see if the 10% will be added automatically for me or I need to do it manually. Okay, now we have the 10% off, as you can see here, and we are now going to pay $90. So this is typically how to set your percentage discount on your plans. Now the next thing we're going to try out here is the fixed cart discount. Applies to everything in your cart. Unlike the first one, works with amounts and not percentage. The first one works with percentage. But this second one, there is no percentage. It subtracts the coupon amount from the cart's subtotal. What do you mean by subtotal? This is the subtotal. Okay, so let's see how to implement this second option, which is fixed card discount. Again, I'm going to my back end, and as soon as I'm here, I'm going to change this from percentage to fixed cards, and I'm going to start with $50. Then if everything remains the same, so I'm going to say update. Now it's been updated. Go back again and reload this page and see what I've got here. So what is actually going on is this. We are going to remove $50 from whatever amount we have in our cards. So this is $50 and not 50%. So our subtotal is 100. So when we remove $50 from 100, we have 50 left. Now this is assume we have 3 products. Now what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to remove 2 products, and I want to be left with just 1. So for this, I remove the $20 products or plan. Then remove the $30 plan as well. Now I'm left with the $50 plan. Here we have a $50 coupon. So 50 minus 50 is going to give us 0. So this simply means this user is paying nothing. This user decides to buy this plan. He proceeds to checkout and he doesn't pay nothing. That's because the $50 coupon code has been applied. So you have to be careful when applying coupons. After creating the coupons, you have to try them out yourself and see how it goes before you now send it out to your users. So we have tried this, and you have tried this as well. In case you don't understand, try to rewind this video and you have a better understanding. This one says a coupon of $50 on a $50 product gives you 0, because when you subtract $50 from the $50 products, when you subtract the $50 coupon from the $50 product, you have 0. That's what we have here. Now the second one says when you have $100 in your card and you're given a $50 discount, 100 minus 50 will give you 50. And that's how come to this place. Now, the last but not the least is the fixed product discount. Now, for example, we're starting with the 3 plans, and these 3 plans give us $100. Then our coupon amount is going to be set to 50. Again, this is $50 and not 50% off. This is $50. So let me go and implement this one. Now I go to my back end. Choose the fixed product discount, and here I choose the $50 as well. We are good to go. Now I click on updates. I come back to my card and I need to update these cards. So what do we have here? We have a subtotal of 50, and we're having a $50 coupon. The 50 minus 50 is going to give us 0, because we just have a $50 product. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add other products. So here is a simple explanation for number one. If I have a coupon amount of $50 and apply it to a $50 product or plan, then I have a 0, means I'm paying nothing. On the second condition, if I apply a coupon amount of $50 on a $30 plan, I get to pay nothing. And third condition here, if I have a coupon amount of $50 and I want to apply it on a plan of $20, I pay nothing as well. So what happens when I have all the three products and I apply 50% discount on them? Let's go and check that out. So I'm going to add two more products to this. I have the $50, I'm going to add the $20 and the $30 plan as well. With that. So $20 has been added. It's time to add the $30 now. Go back. And here's the $30. Click on purchase. And view cards. And here I have the three plans products, and I have a total of $100. So here is the deal. I have a $0 here, just as I have from my own calculations. So for these three plans, it's calculated on a particular product. And the discount is calculated on the $50 product, and this is it here. And after that, we have a $0 as the outcome. Then the same 50% is calculated on this, which is this one here. And at the end of the day, we have a $0. And same for 20. And here, at the end of the day, we have a $0. So we add up all the $0 we have. We still have a $0. So it means the user is not paying anything to have that plan. And that is why we have 0 over here. Now let's look at the second scenario, whereby this admin is offering a $10 coupon for the plans. So what I do is quickly go to the back end and make my adjustments. Now it's $10 coupon. It is $10 off. So I update, then come to the cart and also update my cart. So now I have a $10 discount. So this one means I'm going to have a $10 discount here, which gives me $40. Here $10 discount gives me $10, and here a $10 discount gives me $20. So when you add 20 plus 10, that gives you 30. And when you add 30 to 40 here, that gives you 70. And that's what we have, a $17 here. Under this third fixed product discount, the discount is calculated on each product, on each of the products. So we now have our total. Now I've taken my time to study this and see the different ways to apply this coupon, and I hope that you understand my explanations. Now before, WooCommerce used to have four of these coupon types, but they have just reduced this to three, and that simply means that there's been some changes, and I advise we take some time to study this so that we don't end up giving our customers services for free instead of actually collecting a small amount for the services. Now thank you for watching this video, and I hope I've been able to explain this coupon the way you understand. Have a nice day, and see you soon. We'll be right back.